the chase. Okay. By the way, when I say finale, this isn't the finale of the whole series, because this is going to actually be like a 2022-21 part broadcast, but this is the end of the direct range of 81. This is the last episode of the direct range of 81, and I'm going to be using the back of this Albert Einstein book because, I mean, if you think about it, he was a genius. He won, like as you see here, he won a 1922 Nobel Physics Prize, so I think it's only right, but I need a page to the back. Oh, God. I'll just use it on this page. And keep it in the book. So that is the thing. So if you see that thing, so you have 180, and as you know, like those things symbolize something divisible by 81. That's 0 times 81. That is 1 times 81. Okay. And as for 80, you have 80, and you have that, and then and then you have 6400, as 80 times 1 is 80. Yeah, exactly. Okay. It's hard to like hold it at the same time. So that is 81 times 1, and that is 81 times 79. Yeah, that's really like all the miracle is. You don't like really have to know about it, but how does this compare to the other one? So, the 1 and the 79 are similar, as like for both those numbers, they're 79 apart, but they're within the range of 81, but barely. But the 2 and 80 don't really compare, as for the 2, they're like only 1 range of 81 apart, and for the other one, like while they obviously coexist on both sides, instead of having 82, you have a 60. So you have 79 of those things. So they compare sort of well. It's just that they don't compare well enough. See, like if you have a range of 81 with like 100, 1700 is the best, and 6400 is the worst. And this really has to go back to, like, if you go all the way back to, like, when we were discussing 19, you'd know why. Ooh, money. See, like, also 16 times 76, and now you're at, I have 200, I believe. I'm not really sure how this works. No, you have 400, and that's the same as 76. So, like, it's complicated.